Okay, so we have a beam shown in this figure, which is W36 by 210. Okay, so standard wide flange section. It is laterally supported at A and B. So sa ends ng beam, lateral supported siya. Automatic yun, ha? Pagka may supports, automatic na the beam is always laterally supported on its supports. No? So hinge roller, okay, so laterally supported din siya doon sa hinge at roller, always yun. Kahit maging fixed support, lateral supported din yun. Basta at any support, the beam is lateral supported at that point. Okay, so we have a 250 kip load, service live load applied at the midspan, concentrated load. Using factored loads, compute for the C sub B, okay, yung question letter A, solve for C sub B, do not include the beam self-weight. So, exhibit, for the first question A, ang load lang natin is a concentrated load at the midspan, wala raw kasing self-weight. Solve for that C sub B. Pero yung sa question letter B, solve for CB again, but this time, meron daw lateral support na pinrovide sa midspan. So, lalagyan mo siya ng lateral support sa midspan. At the same time, we have to include the beam self-weight. So, ang beam self-weight, pag kinonsider mo sa beam, it would serve as a uniform load, uniform dead load. Okay, so let's see how to solve it. Okay, sa una, meron lang tayong concentrated load. Ito yon. Pinactor ko lang siya. Tapos, walang uniform load, wala kasing self-weight. So, sinolve ko lang yung beam, inanalyze ko lang beam, syempre, meron siyang reaction. Then, from that reaction, I draw the shear diagram. And from the shear diagram, I drew the moment diagram. So, for case A, ang L sub B natin is yung full length niya. Okay? So, the L sub B natin is 20 feet. So, how do we solve for the C sub B here? So using the formula that we have, diba? So we need to identify the M max, the MA, B, and C. So since ang LB natin ay yung full length na 20 feet, so sa entire moment diagram, the maximum moment is 2,000. Okay, so yun yung M max. At the same time, yun din yung MB. Yung MB kasi is defined as the moment at the midspan of the LB. So sa gitna ng LB, yun yung MB. So, yung M max is just equal to MB also. Tapos, yung MA naman, that is the moment at the 1/4 of its LB. Diba? LB over 4, 1/4. So, yun yung MA. Tapos, ano yung MC? Yung MC naman, ito naman yung nasa 3/4. 3/4 of LB. And by symmetry, yung MA is just equal to MC. And since linear naman yung moment diagram, so we could easily identify that MA and MC are just half of the 2,000. Ayan, so the M max equals MB, which is 2,000 kip inch, while the MA and the MC are both equal to kalahati ng 2,000, which is 1,000. Substituting all these moment magnitudes in the CB equations, we got CB equals 1.316. Actually, in solving for CB, irregardless na yung load, eh, no? Kahit P mo lang siya ilagay, in terms of P, makakancel lang naman din yun, you will arrive with the same value of the C sub B. Kasi mapa-factor out lang naman siya as a function of P. Okay? Now, ano yung second question? Yung second question naman is kapag ka may uniform load, that would come from the self-weight. Oh, given naman yung wide flange section, 'di ba, yung W by 210, yung 210 yun yung pinaka-weight niya in pounds per foot. Okay? So, pwede mong tignan yung self-weight niya from the steel manual. Ito yung nakuha ko, 0.252. Kung hindi man available yung steel manual, pwede kang gumamit na yung weight na 210 pounds per foot. Okay? So, convert mo na lang yun sa kips, etc. Ayun. So, di ba yan nangyari dito? May concentrated load tayo sa gitna, tapos may uniform load pa tayo coming from the self-weight of the beam. Tapos, may lateral support pa siyang dinagdag sa gitna, sa midspan. Okay. So, ang first thing that you have to identify is ano ang LB? Kanina, ang LB natin sa part A is yung 20 feet. Dito sa pangalawa, sa letter B, ang LB na natin ay kalahati na kasi mayroon tayong lateral support sa midspan. So ito na ngayon yung LB natin, which is 10 feet na lang. So kung nasaan yung LB, doon tayo mag-identify. Yun lang yung concern natin na moment diagram. So since uniform load tayo, so yung moment diagram natin becomes second degree. Diba? May second degree curve na tayo. Unlike yung kanina, straight line. Madali lang pag straight line. Okay, so dito tayo mag-identify ng mga moments. So from point, from the first point up to the lateral support dun sa midspan, yun yung LB natin. So among, from that range of LB, the maximum moment obviously is ito. So yan yung maximum moment. Tapos ito yung nasa 1/4 ng LB, MA. Ito yung nasa 1/2 ng LB, MB. At saka yung MC ay nasa 3/4 ng LB. Okay? So, hindi siya madali. I mean, we cannot identify the magnitudes of this MA, MB, MC from the moment diagram kasi second degree siya. Magagamit tayo ng squared property of the parabola to do that. So, it would be a lot easier to identify these moments by projecting it upward by method of members. So, you cut the member, then isolate. Then, identify the moment at that cut section. So, ganun yung ginawa ko. So, the maximum moment, 2012, I got this from the moment diagram, maximum moment. Tapos yung MA by method of members, no, I project that point MA up above here. Then you cut the beam, isolate. So, that is the reaction to 2.52 times distance, 2.5, minus the uniform load times the 2.5 times the moment arm, kalahati ng 2.5. So, we got this as to be the moment at point A at 1/4 of LB. Tapos ganun din yung gagawin ko sa MB. Ang MB naman is located at 1/2 of the LB. 1/2 of LB is 5 feet. Okay, so reaction times moment arm minus the uniform load times the 5 times the moment arm divided ayon equals the moment at B. Same true with the moment at C. After solving all these moments within the LB, so substitute these moments to the CB equation. So using the CB equation, so we got CB equals 1.6637. So ganun lang ang pagkuha ng C sa B. Always focus your attention on the moments within the LB. So pagka naiiba yung LB mo, malamang may iba rin yung mga magnitudes ng mga moments mo na MA, MB, MC, at saka Mmax. Question about this slide?